Difficulty paying attention, non-stop talking, and having trouble staying still are all indicators of ADHD. So what is ADHD? ADHD stands for Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder, and this is a common mental disorder that commonly starts during childhood and can continue into teenage years and adulthood. With ADHD, there are major problems with executive functions leading to difficulty maintaining attention, being hyperactive, and becoming very impulsive. ADHD can often make it difficult for a child to flourish in school. This is because the child may find it very hard to focus on a task that they find boring. However, if they are interested, then they can easily maintain focus. The symptoms must persist for longer than 6 months for a diagnosis to be made. It is important to note that this must be gauged according to the age of the child and their surroundings, as a majority of children are easily distracted and can be very boisterous. And as a result, parents often incorrectly complain that their child is hyperactive. ADHD is thought to affect about 1 to 5% of children, with boys being 3 times as likely to have the condition than girls. Despite it being the most commonly studied mental disorder in children, very little is known about what causes it. But there are 3 factors that are related to its occurrence. The first of these are heredity. Children whose parents have ADHD are more likely to have the disorder. The second is having a neurobiological disorder. This increases the chances of developing ADHD. It is largely believed that an impairment in the brain's neurotransmitter systems, in particular dopamine and noradrenaline, are associated with developing ADHD. Lastly, environmental factors may also contribute to developing the disorder. The general symptoms of ADHD are inattention, hyperactivity, and impulsivity. Other symptoms tend to fall into one of these categories, for example, forgetfulness, anger management issues, mood swings, procrastination, and having an increased risk of addiction. People may have a problem with inattentiveness, but not be impulsive or hyperactive. This condition is known as attention deficit disorder, or ADD, and it is a subtype of ADHD. There is no cure for attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, but there are treatments that can be used to help people with the disorder. This is often a combination of behavioural therapy and medication. The first line treatment in children with mild to moderately severe form of the disorder is the use of behavioural therapies. This includes encouraging the child to do certain behaviours such as completing homework, and the child is rewarded for good behaviour and can have certain privileges removed for bad behaviour. Cognitive behavioural therapy can also be used, as well as psychoeducation. Medications can also be used. There are 4 types. These are methylphenidate, dexamphetamine, lisdexamphetamine, and atomoxetine. These medications aim to allow the patient to feel less impulsive and to feel calm to allow them to concentrate. Methylphenidate, dexamphetamine, and lisdexamphetamine work in a similar way, in that they are stimulants and work by increasing the brain activity, particularly in areas responsible for attention and behavior. Atomoxetine works differently. It is a selective noradrenaline uptake inhibitor, meaning it increases the levels of noradrenaline in the brain, leading to improved concentration. Thank you for watching today's video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below, and don't forget to subscribe to get more videos. I hope you have a great day.